Could you have a dangerous blood clot? Understanding and diagnosing venous thromboembolism, or VTE. The body creates blood clots to help stop bleeding and help wounds heal. For example, scabs are blood clots on the skin that form to stop bleeding from a cut or injury. Clots also form when we have injuries inside the body. Most of the time, the body will get rid of the blood clot once the injury or wound heals. However, sometimes these clots can cause problems. Blood clots form in blood vessels within the body. Blood clots in veins close to the skin are usually not serious. However, when blood clots form in deep veins of the legs, hips, pelvis, or rarely in the arms, neck, or chest, they can be dangerous and require immediate medical attention. Another word for veins is venous. A medical term for a blood clot is a thrombus. When this thrombus or blood clot breaks off and travels from one vein to another part of the body, it is called an embolus. Therefore, VTE stands for venous thromboembolism. A clot which forms in a deep vein in the body is called a DVT, or deep vein thrombosis. A clot that breaks off from a deep vein in the body and travels to the lungs is called a PE, or a pulmonary embolism. Most DVTs are clots that form in veins in the legs, hips, or pelvis area. DVTs can sometimes form in the arms, neck, or chest area. These deep clots clog up the veins and slow down the blood flow, which can cause many symptoms. Warning signs of a possible DVT or clot in a deep vein include pain in one leg or arm, swelling, usually in one leg or arm, skin that is red or not the usual color, and or warmth in the area that has the swelling. If you have had any of these signs of DVT, you should see a doctor right away. Of note, some people with DVT have no signs or symptoms. When a blood clot breaks off and moves to the lungs, it is called a pulmonary embolism, or PE. This is a serious condition and requires rapid medical attention. You should get emergency help if you have any of these warning signs of a blood clot or PE in your lungs. Trouble catching your breath or breathing fast for no reason. Pain in your chest, which may be worse when taking a deep breath. A fast heartbeat for no reason. Dizziness, fainting, or passing out. And/or coughing up blood. A big clot in the lung, or PE, can keep blood from getting to the lungs, cause heart trouble, and may be deadly. If the clot in the lungs is recognized and you get the right care, you can recover from a PE. Damage to the lungs by a clot, or PE, can cause scarring of the lung blood vessels or other parts of the lung. Dangerous blood clots can happen to anyone, but two risk factors make them more likely to happen. Not moving for a long time, such as on a long trip or when staying in bed because you are sick or hurt, and staying in the hospital or having surgery, such as hip or knee surgery. Other risk factors include smoking, being overweight, having an injury or trauma, having family members who have had blood clots, having cancer, taking birth control pills, having a baby, and/or being older. The more of these risk factors you have, the more likely you are to develop VTE blood clots. If you suspect a dangerous blood clot, see your doctor, who will ask about your symptoms and examine you. Remember, if you have pain, swelling, redness, or warmth in one leg, or if you have trouble breathing, pain in your chest, fast heartbeat, dizziness or fainting, or if you cough up blood, see your doctor or call 911 immediately. Different tests are used to find clots in the body. An ultrasound uses sound waves to form a picture of the clot inside the veins of your body. A blood test for D-dimer indicates if your blood contains a chemical substance called D-dimer, which clots leave behind when they break up. You might need other tests, such as a computerized tomography scan or CT scan of the lungs with intravenous or IV contrast, or a ventilation perfusion or VQ lung scan. These scans can show where the clot or clots are in the lungs. VTE blood clots can cause lifelong health problems and can be life-threatening. If you have risk factors for VTE, you should discuss these with your doctor so that you can lower your chances of having VTE. If you have any signs of a dangerous clot, see a nurse or doctor right away so you can get proper care. It could save your life.